Now, I want to finish on this note. In America, they're doing surveys. They're saying the American flag may be alienating some people. We've had the same nonsense in Australia. I want to go through each of you individually. Should we be changing the flag of Australia? John Ruddock.
Absolutely not. It's a beautiful flag, and I'm very proud that it's got a quarter of it represents the Union Jack. What the British Empire did for this world was magnificent. It lifted people up all around the world. And you know, when people see the Australian flag, they know that
John, I need to move on because I want to give everyone else a chance. Liz Storer, should we care if the Australian flag alienates anyone?
Well, it doesn't. And that's why it's important that we don't change it, because we see this constant barrage. They've got the same in the States. The New York Times recently got in trouble for publishing an article that suggested that certain people found the American flag alienating now around their 4th of July celebrations. That was coming up. We need to come together as Australians and say, look, no matter what colour or creed you're from, this is Australia. And what it really is so unfortunate, Corey, is it means that they've created any kind of patriotism, any kind of nationalism, which is not a dirty word. They're trying to scare people off being proud of their country and what they are today.
Liz, I'm sorry. I've got it. I just want to get the last word from Caroline. Stick with our flag. Say no to the people who want to change it, Caroline.
We should absolutely stick with our flag. And what we need to understand is that this is not the view of the average punter. This here is a narrative of the left. It is designed to polarise, and it is designed to ostracise, and it is divisive. And the more reasonable heads amongst us should not take any heed of it.